It is my pleasure now to invite Reverend Father Thomas Aikera, CMI, Rector of Dharmaran College, to nourish us with his words of wisdom.
Your Eminence, Oswald Cardinal Gracious, the President of CBCI, Your Grace Archbishop Salvatore Pinacchio, our Apostolic Nuncio, Your Beatitude Basilius Marclevis, Major Archbishop of the Sri Malangara Church, Dear Reverend Father General, President of the CRI Priest Section, Reverend Father Michael, the Secretary of the Priest Section, dignitaries in the audience, Reverend Fathers, Sisters and Brothers. I deem it my great and pleasant privilege to extend to you all a very cordial welcome in the name of Dharmaran College and all its institutions on the campus, namely Dharmaran Vidya Kshetra, a theological institute, Christ University with all its various units on the campus and off the campus, Christ Group of Schools, and all the departments of varied service. We at Dharmaran are happy and grateful that CRI Priest Section has chosen our campus as the venue of the Congress. At the very outset, let me wish you all the best for this very commendable initiative and pray for God's abundant blessings. We are in the second week after the great feast of Easter. May the risen Lord breathe on us His Holy Spirit so that we get empowered for a broader and brighter vision of mission, as He did during His encounter with His disciples after His resurrection. Let the light shine brighter be our fervent prayer these days. We are called and sent to become a light to the world as the Israelites were, as the church is, and each one of us is destined to be. This mission Congress, I understand, is not merely an academic exercise, but more a spiritual experience in sharing, in praying together, in searching, in surrendering to the stirrings of the Spirit. We, consecrated persons, are specially called to be transformed into light for others. We cannot be light to others unless we have light within us. Let us not forget that light, by its very nature, is self-diffusive. It cannot but shine for others. My sincere wish and earnest prayer is the following. Let this Congress organized by the CRI deepen our basic conviction that religious and priestly consecration is essentially evangelizing and missionary. Let this searching and sharing experience in prayer motivate us for more innovative and creative steps in our commitment to mission. Let it fan the spark within us into a fantastic flame. Let us try to mold a new vision of mission, a mission not only of eloquent preaching of the Gospels, but more of an authentic living of the Gospels. Let us get our vision broadened, simultaneously rooted in the Church in India with its rich diversities and generously directed to the Universal Church. It is high time, I feel, that CRI should take more innovative and inspiring steps in the direction of a new vision and a new reimagining of the mission with well thought out plans for the benefit of the church all over the world. CRI has already started working at it with a consultation Indian missionaries abroad held in January last, I am aware of it. It is indeed a significant start. I do hope and pray that this CRI Mission Congress will deepen our faith, strengthen our collective attitude of determination to commit ourselves more generously to this perennial call to be an eloquent and vibrant gospel, a shining light to the world. Let us bear in mind that determination is the secret of success. Let Jesus, the light par excellence, shine brighter within us in all what we do, in all our institutions, above all, in our very presence. Let us try to make our very life a light that shines incessantly and everywhere. This is my fond hope and fervent prayer. Thank you all.